Hi folks, welcome to the first video review of the Grease Parking Blog. In this edition, we bring you Fiat Linea T-Jet. That's right, the turbocharged version of the well-known Fiat Linea. A 1.4-liter engine producing 114 horsepower. What more could an enthusiast want? Okay, so let's move on to the looks of the car. As you can see, we have the classy Fiat Linea lines, which have always been looking good. There are few differences in the T-Jet version and the regular Linea. The first big thing is the 16-inch rims that give them stock, pretty good, and pretty broad tyres, 205 to be precise. Moving towards the side, again as I said, the classic Fiat Linea lines. I love the chrome inserts and the colour goes well too. One more big thing is, if you see, they have given rear disc brakes too. I don't think many manufacturers in this class give these things, but still, good, nice safety feature. Coming to the rear of the car, pretty balanced boot, pretty balanced profile. One big differentiation is the big T-Jet logo. That's why people need to see that you have a turbocharged Linea. And the chrome tip exhaust. So on the inside, the car pretty much complements its wonderful exteriors. Very nice and balanced and sculpted steering wheel, really for the enthusiast, with leather covering and stitching on it. It has the steering mounted controls for the music system and Windows Blue & Me system. I pretty much liked it. The Bluetooth connectivity, calling and all is pretty easy, and the system also reads out the SMSs. Moving to the dials, a pretty nice and retro look given to the dials. Looks good, and if you have noticed, the tachometers in the Fiat cars, they're always into 100 compared to the other cars which show in 1000, so it's 0, 10, 20. I like that small nifty feature. The panel overall, pretty good layout, again chrome inserts, but I personally didn't like the look and feel of this plastic surrounds, but nothing much to complain about. Overall, the dashboard, a very nice color combination given. Looks good in the contrast and has a really upmarket feel to it. Door cards are also pretty good, well sculpted, look nice and definitely complement the exterior. There are many small nice nifty features like these lights underneath, which you would definitely find useful. I also like the roof fabric, has a nice feel and touch to it, again giving the upmarket feel. This is obviously the top of the range version of the Linea, and they have also given leather covers. There's one more small thing I pretty much adore, is this nice and nifty armrest, which again has storage space in it. Nice gear lever, feels good to shift, has a very positive shift to it. Overall, again, I rate the interiors pretty good. The rear of the car again has a very nice and plush feel to it, but space is at a premium. That is one point I would like to complain about. And since the car has a coupe like styling, headroom is again a bit low. And moving to the features over here, we have a very nice air vent, which actually is very useful and cools decently. And there's a very nice feature over here which I like, is the armrest. It comes down and there's space for a small party, if you know what I mean. The headrests again are adjustable, and they have given a very nice blind over here, again complementing the upmarket feel and look of the entire car. Well, it's a drive of the car where it actually impresses us the most. It is well known that Fiat cars do handle very nicely and have very nice ride quality, and the Linea doesn't disappoint on that part either. The handling is one of the best I've ever driven, at least in this range. The mid-range of the engine is pretty strong, and though the top end is a bit weak, because of the strong mid-range, daily cruising and city traffic driving is pretty easy. The ride quality of the car is something to write home about. Right now we are driving on a pretty bad stretch of road, and yet the car gives a very solid yet compliant feel. And despite such a nice ride quality, it doesn't disappoint on the handling part. No understeer, and sharp turns, 80 speed, we've done everything. The car doesn't reach its limit at all. Another big thing about the Fiat is that they don't give electric power steering. The steering is hydraulic, and that means that it has tons of feel to it. You instantly understand what the front two wheels are doing, and it's a very joyful and emotional drive with this car, I must say. Just as you saw, the car is pretty stable at high speeds, cornering at high speeds, and even braking. I would like to say that, just like the ad says, admiration guaranteed. The car doesn't disappoint at all. Yes, at a few places like rear legroom, headroom, definitely aimed at the enthusiast. But still, even if you're not one, you'll definitely enjoy this car. That's the feeling I need it for you.